Tonight, an artist examining pieces of history, her own and from her native land of Iran. Jeffrey Brown has our report.
Faces from Iran, still images, and films. The work of an artist looking from afar at the dramas and traumas of her native land.
I would say that I make fictions, and I
think... You make fictions?
Yeah.
But out of reality?
Exactly. I think the creative imagination, art, is in essence something that takes reality and yet transforms it into something that is fictional.
Shirin Neshat grew up in pre-revolutionary Iran. She came to the U.S. in the 1970s as a student and became an internationally recognized artist with exhibitions around the world. Her latest at Washington's Hirshhorn Museum is titled Facing History.
Do you see yourself that way as an artist, facing, looking at history?
On a subconscious level, yes. When I first went back to Iran after the Islamic Revolution, when I had been absent for 11 years, when I arrived in Iran in 1990, I was quite blown away by the transformation of the country. And I had also an incredible urge to reconnect to Iran. So art, in a way, became an excuse to reconnect to my home, my family, and the country.
The exhibition begins in the period of the U.S.-backed overthrow of the government of Mohammad Mossadegh in 1953. But this is history through poetic imagery, as in Neshat's film, Munis. Here, a young Iranian woman falls to her death and then has a magical conversation with a slain protester in which she ponders her own role in society. Neshat's series, Women of Allah, explores the impact of the Iranian Revolution and perceptions of Muslim women as being victimized and submissive. These are staged photographs created in her New York studio.
Of course, the situation in Iran has been very oppressive, but opposite to what the image is, the women are extremely rebellious. They're very vocal, very confrontational, and by no means submissive.
Neshat herself appears in much of her work, embodying the characters she seeks to portray. Layered onto many of her images, she adds intricate calligraphy.
I handwrite the calligraphy on the surface of the photographs. There is the labor of the artist. I'm very interested in literature, Iranian contemporary and modern literature. They're not decorative, they're not Quranic texts. They are my favorite poems by my favorite poets.
Give me an example. Here's one of an eye.
Yes.
That has the writing right in the eye, right?
Yes. This image was actually created, one of the first images that I produced. It was in 1993. It's called Offered Eyes. And it was the poetry that inspired me to shoot this photograph. The poem is called I Feel Sorry for the Garden. Obviously, the garden being a metaphor for a woman.
A more recent body of work is a response to the 2009 Green Movement that was violently put down by the Iranian regime. It's called The Book of Kings, a reference to an ancient epic poem about the Persian Empire, the Shahnameh. The series, again using models, is divided into three parts: the masses, the patriots, and the villains.
This body of work is more about the question of people versus tyranny. People who fight power and people who hold power, people whose desire and beliefs in whatever it is always intersected with violence and atrocities.
They're beautiful images. Do you feel that tension of beauty and violence?
Absolutely. I think that notion of contradiction, paradox, opposites is at the core of my work. I feel as a woman, as an Iranian, completely conflicted by who I am in nature, someone again very tough and strong, but also extremely fragile, but also my identity as a Muslim, as a Persian, as a Westerner, as an Easterner. So my work is exactly that expression of that sense of duality that I feel that is the core of who I am.
Shirin Neshat, Facing History, is on exhibition through September 20th. From the Hirshhorn Museum in Washington, D.C., I'm Jeffrey Brown for the PBS NewsHour.